Hi viewers, I'm Dr. Lakshmi from Vishnu Educational Development and Innovation Center, Hyderabad. Today in this video, I'm presenting about fundamentals of Fourier transform and its applications through analogy, piano example, radio signal, working principle of radio knobs like bass and treble, how the images are processed using Photoshop or any other softwares, as well as few more applications of the Fourier transform. Imagine that one day afternoon, you feel hungry and come home after outing, feeling like eating. Luckily, your mom had prepared your favorite carrot sambar. Unfortunately, on that day, your mom had added more asafoetida. Actually, you don't like asafoetida. In Telugu, ingua. Suppose you don't like vegetable or onion, you can remove it easily from the cooked sambar. But it is tough to remove asafoetida from the cooked sambar because it is a solvent. Let us imagine, suppose at your home, there is a machine having several filters to collate each of the ingredients like mustard, salt, sambar powder, oil, onion, vegetable, coriander leaves and asafoetida, etc. Well, imagine you had a few filters lying around. In this picture, for the convenience, I'm using only 3 filters. But in the sambar, more than 50 ingredients would have been added. Let us imagine the first filter is meant for collecting only the vegetable. Second filter is meant for collecting only the salt. Third filter is meant for collecting the asafoetida. Pour the sambar through the first filter, it collects only the vegetables and it filters the rest of the sambar. Then pour through the second filter, it collects only the salt, and pour through the third filter, it collects only the asafoetida. Now it becomes easy for us to remove the constituent asafoetida, which we don't like, from the sambar. Now we can apply reverse engineer the recipe by filtering each ingredient. This filter's property must be independent. Each and every filter is independent from other filters. Filter must be complete. It must collect that particular item completely. Ingredients must be combinable. The rest of the ingredient later on, it is easy for us to combine. What does the Fourier transform do? Imagine this entire machine is a Fourier transform. Given a sambar, it finds the recipe, it finds the ingredients. How? Run the sambar through filters to extract each ingredient. Why in this presentation sambar analogy is considered? Recipes are easier to analyze, compare and modify than the smoothie itself, than the original signal processing itself. How do we get the sambar back? Remove the asafoetida, blend the rest of the ingredient, you will get your favorite sambar now. How good it would be? Are you happy? Yes. The Fourier transform is one of the deepest insights ever made. Unfortunately, the meaning is buried within the dense equations rather than the symbols. Let's experience the key idea firsthand in this video. Imagine that similar kind of sambar machine is available, or the approach is used in television, computer and mobile or other kind of electronic devices in our daily life. It's a mathematical concept named Fourier transform. In this video, again, I'm presenting about what does the Fourier transform do? How it is useful in signal processing, why we have to use Fourier transform, what is the meaning of time domain signal and frequency domain signal, what is the mathematical terms called as convolution and deconvolution, what is the meaning of inverse Fourier transform, etc. Let us imagine or consider the piano having 88 keys. All the left-hand keys will generate low frequency signal. Similarly, right side keys will generate high frequency signals. In the piano, keys are arranged from low frequency to the high frequency. Let us see what is the meaning of frequency. Now, Imagine that you are pressing this key. Actually, the left hand side is a low frequency signal. If you press the left side key, that could generate 30 hertz low frequency signal. Let us imagine. What is the meaning of hertz or frequency? This signal having 30 cycles per second, so that you will hear 30 times of the same kind of signal in a second. So you could hear low pitch sound. This is a simple sine wave. Simple sine wave, but sine wave itself has its own complication for generating it. Similarly, if we press the right side key, it could generate 5000 hertz signal. Let us imagine. You will hear 5000 times of the same kind of signal in a second. That is why you could hear high pitch. From the above example, you could understand that both of the signals are clear sine waves, or a simple signal. Hence, it is easy to process. Suppose consider the complex signal or combined signal. Processing such a signal would be little complicated process than processing simple sine waves. If we understand how the complex signals are formed or generated, it becomes easy for us to process. Suppose if we press three keys at a time in the piano, key 1, key 2, key 3, all the three keys, if we press at a time in the piano, that could generate three different sound signals or sine waves. This key releases or generates the low frequency sound signal. This key generates little bit higher frequency sine wave signal or sound signal. This key generates higher frequency sine wave or sound signal. Suppose if we press all the keys at a time, we could hear the combined signals of all the three. Combined signals only we could able to hear. Now processing such a kind of complicated signal or combined signal becomes equivalent to the separation of a asafoetida from the sambar, as I mentioned earlier. But if we could separate each signal, signal processing becomes easier. Separating the complicated signal into simple sine waves could be done using Fourier transform. Let us see now the terminology time domain output signal. The original signal or combined signal or complex signal is mathematically termed as time domain output signal. If we apply Fourier transform with the combined signal, then it generates simple signal or separated sound signal or simple sine waves. Fourier transform helps us in converting the time domain signal to frequency domain output signal. Time domain signal, otherwise termed as analog signal or continuous signal. Frequency domain signal, otherwise termed as discretized signal. Let us consider the radio signal. At the receiver end, original audio signal is combined or mixed with noise signal during the transmission. But removal of the noise signal becomes difficult when we deal with the time domain signal, that is original signal. Hence, we must use the Fourier transform to convert the time domain to frequency domain signal. Now it becomes easy to remove the noise signal. After the process, we could hear the radio programs without noise signal. For example, imagine that after the separation of the combined signal into simple waves, then let us imagine the second wave or sine wave is meant for noise signal. Easily it could be removed. Then combining rest of other signal, we will get back the original or with a good quality audio. Similarly, when you adjust the bass and treble knobs in your radio, it converts the input signal into frequency domain using Fourier transform. separating the combined signal into simple sine waves or simple form of waves is termed as mathematically convolution. And working on every constituent or every separated signal, for example, this may be a noise signal you want to remove, this signal you may want to amplify, this signal you may want to modify, the process of working on individual signal is termed as deconvolution. Then, after the alteration, combining all the signals and converting into analog signal or combined signal and sends back to the speaker, then this process is called inverse Fourier transform. Some of the applications of the Fourier transforms are, in our computer, we used to convert the raw image into JPEG for the size reduction or to compress the image. Sometime we try to improve the picture quality. The way we separate the complicated audio signal into multiple sine waves, the same phenomena we can apply to separate complex image signal into multiple sine waves. Suppose in this picture, we would like to remove the colors, then we have to use Fourier transform to convert it into frequency domain. Mathematically, this process is called convolution. Combined signal, it's termed as otherwise time domain output signal or analog signal. Then this signal is using Fourier transform converted into separate simple sine forms, sine waveforms. This process is termed as convolution. The separated signals are termed as frequency domain output signal. Then working on the separated signal, whatever the way, whatever the mathematical formula we want to apply, whatever the way we want to modify or alter or amplify, then the process is termed as deconvolution. Now imagine this is the signal meant for colors or color, one of the color. Then if we remove this entire sine form, then it will become gray color image. Then after the removal of this simple sine wave or working on the separated signal, the process is called deconvolution. Then combining the rest of the signals or all the altered signals, then the process is called inverse Fourier transform. With the support of Fourier transform, we are all enjoying audio signals, video signals, multimedia signals. We are using television and radio. We are enjoying recent day using mobile. Life becomes easy and comfortable. It is only because of Fourier transform. Aerospace is an yet another application of Fourier transform, quantum mechanics, and astrophysics. I hope you would have understood and enjoyed learning the applications of fundamentals of Fourier transform. I thank these two URLs, our online contributors, and interactive guide to the Fourier transform, Let Us Make Engineering Simple. Especially I thank Let Us Make Engineering Simple LMES team and Mr. Premanand for courtesy reusing their video for the educational purposes. I have shared both of the URL in the description too. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe the channel for notifications. Wish you all success.